हम शुरू करते हैं, लेट अस सी द स्ट्रेंथ एंड वीकनेसेस, राइट? क्या स्ट्रेंथ है? गुड, इट इज गुड दैट यू आर आंसरिंग, आप आंसर दे रहे हो, मुझे बड़ा अच्छा लग रहा है। चलिए, सो लेट अस सी स्ट्रेंथ्स ऑफ इंडिया। इंडियाज डेमोग्राफिक डिविडेंड। सो एज ऑफ नाउ वी डोंट हैव द डेमोग्राफिक डिविडेंड, राइट? नाउ वी हैव द अपॉर्चुनिटी, वी हैव द डेमोग्राफिक अपॉर्चुनिटी, विंडो ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटी, ठीक है? सो वी कैन कन्वर्ट दिस लार्ज वर्कफोर्स, वी कैन कन्वर्ट द वर्कफोर्स इनटू द डेमोग्राफिक डिविडेंड with suitable policies like focusing upon the skill, focusing upon the good jobs and good health, ठीक है? So we have the good amount of workforce coming up, ठीक है? Our population is young comparatively, ठीक है? So India's demographic dividend, and we are also having the high domestic demand. हमारी जो demand है वो भी काफी अच्छी है। Our people are moving from the poor to the middle class and from the middle class to the rich class status. Therefore, they require more amount of goods, durable and other goods. Their consumption needs are increasing. So, there is increasing domestic demand. Then, we have also built a strong foundation of democracy. So, because of this democracy, our future is comparatively safe as compared to China. So in China, there is a possibility of revolt in the medium to long term. But in India, the possibilities are very, very less. In India, we are also providing many, many income support to the farmers. We are bringing up various stimulus package, and we are also coming up with the various structural reforms in the form of GST, which is one of the biggest taxation reform, demonetization, insolvency and bankruptcy code, digital policies and focusing upon the demographic dividend. ठीक है? If we talk about China, China is having its own strength which are not available with India. China की खुद की अपनी कुछ strength है। क्या strength है China की? Richa is saying, sir, China democratic country क्यों नहीं है? My friend, on the face they say we are a democratic country, but there is only one political party. All the organizations, military, judiciary, executive, all are affiliated to the same political party, right? So essentially there is no democracy, right? For nomenclature they have the democracy, they say that elections happen, but actually there is no democracy. There is no competition between the different political parties. So their exports are quite high. So this is their strength. This brings their diplomatic strength, as well as this brings lot of foreign exchange reserve to them. Okay. China's manufacturing productivity is also very high as compared to India, right? And their inflation rate is low. So inflation rate is low. That means their एक्सपोर्ट कॉम्पिटिटिवनेस इज गुड, उनकी जो एक्सपोर्ट कॉम्पिटिटिवनेस है वो अच्छी है। नाउ द वीकनेसेस, प्लीज टेक 30 सेकेंड्स एंड राइट डाउन द वीकनेसेस। So, if we talk about weaknesses, if you talk about China, definitely they are now having a lot of tensions with the USA. Like there are a lot of trade disputes going on, and recently after this COVID situation, the entire world is criticizing China. So in the short to medium term, definitely they will be getting less investment, right? So they will not get the sympathy of anyone that will adversely impact their investment. But their growth will not be impacted much because they already have good amount of investment. There are certain areas where no one can compete China, right? So because of their lower cost of production, their good manufacturing productivity, and their large global supply chain, they are not defeatable easily. ठीक है? So even after this COVID, my estimate is that China will not be impacted much as far as economy is concerned. But definitely, because of this trade tension which were going on between India, between China and USA, there will be some impact, right? Although in China there is single party, most of the enterprises are state run, but comparatively they are less efficient and not innovative as compared to India, where we are actually innovative, we are competitive, we have the industry like IT industry. So nowadays we can see we are coming up with the good IT, like after the 1991 only we had very good IT industry, right? And we are also focusing upon the innovation, right? So as compared in China, this is one of the weakness they are having. Apart from that, their one child policy that will actually increase their demographic burden. Right? So in the upcoming years, their workforce will reduce and the people who are dependent, they will increase. If you see India, there are many issues with the service sector, especially, right? So we say service sector is our strength, but there are various issues with the service sector, right? And then in India, we are talking about the labor reforms, but we are not able to bring the labor reforms. Our skill development policies are just for the namesake. We have not been able to develop our skills. Our infrastructure is also very, very weak. So all of these issues are there, right? Now, experts say that China and India, the comparison is unfair, right? Comparison उनके बीच में करना ठीक नहीं है. Yes, so Shivam, they have actually liberalized this policy. ठीक है, तो one child policy they have liberalized already. So India versus China, is there even a comparison? So experts say that economy of China is at least 5 times as big as economy of India. तो इंडिया इकोनॉमी जो चाइना की इकोनॉमी है वो इंडिया के कंपैरिजन में बहुत ज्यादा है, राइट? सो चाइना साइज इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 15 ट्रिलियन डॉलर, इंडिया साइज इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 3 ट्रिलियन डॉलर. अब अगर ये लोग इफ दे आर राइजिंग विद अ ग्रोथ रेट ऑफ जस्ट 1% एंड वी आर राइजिंग with a growth rate of 10%, even then we will not be able to catch them very easily. उसके बावजूद भी हम उनको आसानी से कैच नहीं कर सकते, right? So doing this comparison between India and China is a futile exercise. This is the view of some of the expert. ठीक है? So expert say that the GDP gap between the two countries is going to increase. China is going to overtake USA and India will actually jump to become the third largest economy, right? China's growth rate has been consistently higher than India's growth rate in the past 3 decades, right? So this point was highlighted by the Economic Survey 2017-18. In this economic survey, the experts say those countries which are in a good position today, they maintain their double digit economic growth rate for over 3 decade continuously. उन लोगों ने over three decade they followed double digit economic growth rate, right? That is how China and other countries, developed countries, were able to grow so fast. In India, we never got this 10% growth rate, right? So it is very, very difficult to compete with the China. India's per capita income, again, is, you know, there is a high difference. And in terms of growth rate, soon India will be outperformed by the countries like Bangladesh by 2030. But we can certainly draw some lessons from China, right? So, kya lesson le sakte hain log? Or what other step should India take? Can you think for 30 seconds what should India do? Learning from China or otherwise also? So Rahul's point are good. Increase investment in the infrastructure, export orientation. Good, good. Chaliye. First of all, we should increase the investment, right? And we should focus on the labor intensive industries. So if we see China, China's per capita income is rising. When there is a rise in the per capita income, the wage requirement also increases. The people start demanding more wages. So the labor cost is increasing in China. That is why the industries want to move from China to India, right? In India, we have surplus manpower. The labor cost is comparatively very, very less. So in India, we are talking about coastal employment zones, coastal economic zones, right? We with the help of policies like Sagarmala, we want to establish the port areas as the employment zones where the industries will be coming from China and they will get established. They will provide the jobs. India is also already working on the labor reforms. We should focus upon the infrastructure. So already we are having very good policies like Bharatmala, Sagarmala, Jalmarg Vikas project, right? In the air sector also, Udaan scheme, all these sectors we are already working on, in the railway, in the road, everywhere we are working, right? Then we should focus upon the productivity. We should actually bring the private investment also. So we are already bringing up various models in the PPP, hybrid annuity model, this Swiss challenge model. Again, we are also going for the disinvestment. We are focusing upon strategic disinvestment. So those PSUs which are not making good profit, we are divesting them very in the 100% manner. We are also promoting the urbanization, right? And we are also bringing the export orientation through our policies like Agro Export Policy 2018, and there are various other export infrastructure reforms, right? So we are developing the ports, we are developing the shipping infrastructure, we are reducing the turnaround time of the Indian ships. So with this particular topic is complete. Now, if we talk about how to write the answer. So this is the question, right? This is the question. With the content which I have already discussed, can you write the answer to this question? Kya aap is question ka answer likh sakte ho? While both India and China got freedom at the same time, China emerged as the second largest economy while India lagged behind. Theek hai? तो इसमें इंट्रोडक्शन क्या होगा? बॉडी क्या होगी? कंक्लूजन क्या होगा? ठीक है, तो इन इंट्रोडक्शन यू कैन स्टार्ट अबाउट द कंडीशन एट द टाइम ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस, and you can write some of the recent facts. There is a 5-time difference between the size of two economies, per capita income, etc. Okay. In the body, you can write briefly, right? You can make a table. India's growth story and China's growth story, right? So we have discussed around 10 points. Out of these points, 10 points, you can write 5 points. 5 points in the exam. Okay. तो एग्जाम में आपको ज्यादा टाइम मिलेगा नहीं, आपको सिर्फ 5 पॉइंट लिखेंगे तो भी आपका बहुत रहेगा, क्योंकि ये टॉपिक जो हमने डिस्कस किया है, हमने एसे के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से ये टॉपिक हमारा प्रिपेयर हो चुका है, ठीक है? देन यू कैन आल्सो राइट इन द कंक्लूजन, यू कैन राइट द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ इंडिया, एंड द ग्रोथ लेसन्स, right? So whenever you are writing the answer, I want to tell you something. Please make the structure before you start writing the answer. So the structure which I have made, you should make the structure like this. If this is a question of 150 words, I will write this introduction in around 40 words, this conclusion in around 50 words, and rest 90 words I will write in the body. Okay? तो बॉडी में मेरे पास में आई हैव अराउंड 5 पॉइंट, सो इन ईच पॉइंट आई कैन राइट अराउंड 14 वर्ड्स. ईच एंड एवरी वर्ड आई नीड टू नो दैट हाउ मच वैल्यू एडिशन आई एम गोइंग टू डू. ठीक है, सो इंट्रोडक्शन में 40 वर्ड्स, बॉडी में 90 वर्ड्स एंड कंक्लूजन में 50 वर्ड्स. इफ दिस इज अ 250 वर्ड्स क्वेश्चन, अगर ये 250 वर्ड्स का क्वेश्चन है, इट मीन्स इट इज अ 15 मार्कर. आई विल राइट दिस इंट्रोडक्शन अगेन इन द around 50 words, this conclusion in around 60 words, and I will increase the length of the body. So this body will be around 140 words, right? So similar to this, you need to write the important points, make a structure in the starting of the answer, and then start writing the answer. Okay? You should not take more number of word in any of the component. Introduction में आपको इतने ही word लिखने हैं, body में आपको इतने ही word लिखने हैं, conclusion में आपको इतने ही word लिखने हैं. Now, there can be various ways to write the answer. You can write in the point format, in the paragraph format, in the table format, in the diagram format. You should use a combination in the paper. So if you're writing the 20 questions, you can write 2 questions in the paragraph format, 10 questions in the point format, 5 questions in the diagrams format, right? And rest questions in the table format. You should use a combination. You should not follow blindly that all the questions I am writing in the point format, all the questions in diagram format. That is not suggested. You should use a combination so that examiner is happy when the examiner sees your copy. जब examiner आपकी copy देखेगा तो वो खुश हो. आपको ये कोशिश करनी चाहिए. ठीक है? तो क्या आप ये कोशिश करोगे? चलिए. तो ये हमारा main answer writing का इस पे हमारा हुआ. इसके ऊपर essay भी आ सकता है. ठीक है ना, इसके ऊपर हमारा बिल्कुल एसे भी आ सकता है. दिस इज ए एसे टाइप ऑफ टॉपिक, सो दे कैन ऑलवेज आस्क द एसे, और यू कैन यूज लॉट ऑफ फोडर पॉइंट फ्रॉम दिस पीपीटी इन योर अदर आंसर्स. तो आप अपने आंसर में भी इसके पॉइंट को लिख सकते हो. ठीक है, आप अगर अर्बनाइजेशन का आंसर लिख रहे हो तो भी आप लिख सकते हो, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर का आंसर लिख रहे हो तब भी आप लिख सकते हो, डेमोग्राफी का आंसर लिख रहे हो तब भी लिख सकते हो, एम्प्लॉयमेंट का आंसर लिख रहे हो तब भी. सो यू कैन ऑलवेज टेक ए रेफरेंस from the points which we have given over here, right? So that is how you can use the same matter for writing the different answer. I will send the PPT which I have given here in the Telegram group, so you will get this PPT. You should not worry, right? So